Friends, with the continuation of animal distribution, that is the continuous and discontinuous distribution of organisms in the world. So today I am going to show what are the major important major animals situated or distributed in each continent. The first one is Paleozoic region. The major or important organisms, major group of organisms distributed in this region, just the brown color indicates the Paleozoic region or realms, we call it as, is the llama, red panda, moose is a very rare animal, you can see. Chinese alligators are quite common in this region. Asian salamander is a quite interesting animal you can find here. European salamanders are another interesting organism you can see. Among birds and mammals, you have eggs, sparrows you can find, pond herons you can find, of course the red fox, which is said to be indigenous animal in the in this area, you can see. Some of the clownfishes are very interesting animals you can see here. Rhacoporus, otherwise you know, flying amphibian. Climbing amphibian, just you can see here. And as some of the gara fishes are quite common in this area. Giant panda is a very interesting organism you can find in the Paleozoic. Coming to Nearctic region, where the pocket gopher is very much common, it is burrowing animal. Another burrowing animal is the pocket mouse, is quite common. Kangaroo rats, pronghorns are quite normal in this region. Turkeys are very very common. Shrews, pike gar, otherwise you know, gar fishes are very common fishes you can see here. And some of the channel catfishes are very common you can find, so along with the bowfin fishes. Axolotl larva, it is known for neoteny, actually it is the larva of salamander, so you can find here. So it's a quite interesting animal. It matures even in the larval stage, that is the axolotl larva. Musk turtle is very much common in Nearctic region. American salamander is quite interesting and beautiful colored salamander you can see. Pit viper is very very interesting animal you can look at from here. Monsters, flying squirrels are quite interesting one. Red deer, beavers are very common in the Nearctic region. Neotropical region, which consists of the South American region, where the tapirs are common, armadillo, anteaters, sloths, opossums, electric eels are very very common animals you can find. In the same way, marmosets, tamarins, paca, rhea, goaty, porcupines, toucans, curassows, and cock of the dog that you can see commonly here. Coming to the Ethiopian realms, you are going to see that slender loris is very very common here. Of course, the largest aquatic mammal, that is the hippopotamus, you can see. Gorillas, baboons are very common in the forest area of African region. Ostrich is very common in Central Africa. Cyclops species are very, very common. Black bears are common, African elephant. Spiny lizards are very, very common here. And the giraffes are very much can be seen here. Other than that hard work, African lungfish is very, very indigenous here. Golden moles, Xenopus, and some of the birds you can see, like in this area. Coming to the oriental realms, you have Gevialis, very indigenous to India and the Indian subcontinent. Orangutan is very common, and of course big-headed turtle is very much common. It is a burrowing, feeding on dead animals. It is very, very common. Gibbons are very common here. Colugo is very much indigenous to this area. Peacock, skunk, some of the carps are present. Single-horned rhinoceros is very common. Shield tails are very common organisms you can find in this region. Other than that, spiny dormouse, tortoise, Indian elephant, tarsiers, tree shrews are very, very common here. Coming to Australia, you have lot of biodiversity, like marsupial mouse, marsupial mole, kangaroos, spiny anteaters you can find, wombat, flying langur, Australian lungfish you can find, tiger snake you can find, skink you can find, this duckbill platypus you can find, cockatoo, pygmy parrots, emu, cassowary, other kind of birds you can see, honeysuckers, lories, all these things you can find in the Australian things. Thank you very much for watching this. This is about the distribution of very important organisms in different realms in the world actually. Thank you. Just you follow the next lecture for what are the advantages and what are the barriers for distribution of animals in the world. Thank you very much.